Fear is something that everybody experiences. We all have fear. And fear is a normal response to a threat. The difference with anxiety is that anxiety is more diffuse. It's not specific to a threat. It's more global and it's more vague and general. A fear of elevators could be absolutely rational if you know that the elevator reached the maximum capacity, or you know for sure that it's been failing or is shaking in a strange way. That's rational, and avoiding that is normal. But anxiety would be for someone to be afraid of elevators, even though it's a perfectly functioning elevator, you know it's been recently stalled and checked, technically is flawless, and you still have an anxiety about that. Anxiety disorders is a large family with several individual disorders, but it's important to know that sometimes they happen together, or you may have one and a little bit of another one. But the most common are panic disorder, social anxiety disorder. We have also generalized anxiety disorder, separation anxiety disorder, and the last one is selective mutism. It's a rare disorder that is mostly seen in children. In psychiatry, it's probably the most successful group of illnesses or disorders that we can treat successfully are anxiety disorders. The treatment of choice are therapy. There's multiple therapies that are validated by research that can be effective. In addition to that, we can use medications that are for just as needed for example, panic attacks. Many people use a type of medication called a benzodiazepine. There's a family of medications that are anti-anxiety. They can work for someone who has only sporadic attacks, but not for someone who has chronic, what is called generalized anxiety disorder, because it's easy to become dependent on those medications. The other mainstay type of treatment in terms of medications are antidepressants, specifically the so-called serotonergic antidepressants. Some of them, for example, are sertraline or paroxetine, and these medications increase the transmission of serotonin in the brain and can alleviate some of the symptoms of anxiety. When we are thinking of treatment of anxiety disorders without medication, we have therapy, but also we have self-help. So we can do a lot with self-help. Probably the most effective are all kinds of activities that tend to reduce the activation of the stress response system in the body. So the stress response system releases a number of chemicals like cortisol and adrenaline, but also changes the heart rate, the breathing, and so forth. And so there are many activities, including meditation, yoga, tai chi, and sports in general, aerobic exercise, that can down-regulate the activation of the stress response system. In addition to self-help, another type of non-medication, non-pharmacological treatment for anxiety disorders is therapy, counseling. And there are several types that are specific for anxiety, and they are being developed through research, and they are highly effective. One of the most commonly and most known, well-known, is cognitive behavior therapy, which is a systematic training of the patient to identify certain thoughts and beliefs that can be challenged, and the challenging and switching and reframing and changing those thoughts can alleviate anxiety. The main coping skill for anxiety is avoidance. Unfortunately, avoidance is the worst thing that we can do because it will perpetuate and make it chronic. The more we avoid something, the more powerful that fear becomes, or that anxiety. Therefore, some of the treatments for anxiety is to try not to avoid the triggers, is to expose ourselves as much as we can tolerate that. For example, if public speaking is a source of anxiety, some of us can get trained and go to Toastmasters, for example, and go to a setting that we feel safer and slowly and progressively expose ourselves, because the brain learns to not to react. As with more practice, we lose that fear. And you believe that you have an anxiety disorder, I would say the first thing to do could be a screening for that. That can be done by your primary care physician or yourself. One of the most common tools to screen for anxiety disorder is called the Generalized Anxiety Disorder 7, GAD-7. And that's widely available in the public domain on the internet. And if you have a suspicion of an anxiety disorder, I would go to your primary care doctor. Alternatively, you can go to a therapist, because can be very effective. And the therapist would be prepared to tell you, I think you need medication in addition to therapy.